There's a moment each day when the land seems to awaken into its own remembered Eden, when the night shadows are passing and the uncreated day is revealing itself, pristine and never before. It's a time I like to climb the hill behind my home and greet the elements. It's seldom without a salty wind, and there's a light dancing across the wide bay and the folding hills. It's a beautiful thing to experience, a privilege, an extraordinary sight every ordinary day, and different each time. The lane I follow to work is like that too, ever changing with the seasons, a kaleidoscope of colour, scents and sounds, a feast for the senses if I can slow down enough to let it work its magic in me. It's no more than a short mile from my house door to the workshop, a narrow lane that was old when it was first set down on a parish map some 200 years ago, and it's been gathering layers of vegetation and harbouring the wild ever since. Every acre of this peninsula bears the mark of some hand or hoof, every turf tilled by its tenants going back for thousands of years. But here along this green lane, there's a remnant of the wild. Here between the heaped clay banks and the laboured ditches, a sanctuary. As I pass along it, a storybook opens before me, the chapters following the never-ending cycle of seasons, but different each year. A place constantly in flux, budding, growing, flowering, fruiting, and fading back into the good brown earth again. It's a marvel to me, always something new, some detail that takes my attention and holds me in its thrall. It invites me to be awake, alive in my awareness, and to be grateful. This thin thread of wildness, this haven for such abundance, and for the yearning in the wild that lives in all of us. This humble hedge.